just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway. When you walked among men, well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Pushing and shoving, crowding my mind.
Peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Today, I invite you to join me in welcoming a special guest, our Associate Conference Minister for the Northwest Association, Rob MacDougall. He will be preaching for us today, and I know he will have a great message for us. So thank you, Reverend Rob, for joining us today. And a few other announcements. Wondering whether or not anyone is interested in an adult study via Zoom. If you are, we can set that up. We need your recommended days and times, and even if there's a special focus of study that you would like, please email me directly or contact the church office. And also, via email blast, we sent out a notice that the United Church of Christ National Office is making special face masks available, which very nicely happens to have the word peace right across it. So if this is something that you are interested, again, check your email blast or contact Sue. She will be taking orders for that up until Wednesday of this week. So check it out and get it in. And then also, I want to remind you about the coffee hour via Zoom after every worship service. And Michael always sends out an email blast about how to easily connect to that. And if you have problems, you're welcome to call me if you're having issues connecting. But we would love to see you and see your face anyway and have conversation with you after worship. And now, let us be in worship. Join me in the call to worship. The shepherd's voice calls out to us,
calling each one of us by name.
We know his voice.
We place our full trust in the shepherd.
He goes before us and leads the way.
The way of abundant life made known through Christ Jesus.
Thank you. Please join me in the opening prayer. Shepherding God, we need you. We are like sheep wandering around in a time of uncertainty, lost, afraid, not knowing which way to go. Call out to us again that we may hear your voice. Guide us with your tender care. Direct us in our daily decisions as we journey with you. Lead us in the way of abundant life and warm our hearts to reach out to others in need of your life-giving love and care. We, your sheep, are not only dependent upon you, we are interdependent one with another. Remind us that the abundance in our lives is directly tied up with the welfare of others. Open our spirits to freely share with those in need for the common good of all. In your grace and mercy, we pray. Amen. Scripture reading this morning, the first one, comes from Acts chapter 2. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. All came upon everyone because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. And the second scripture comes from the Gospel of John. This is actually the passage that precedes the scripture that we heard a few weeks ago. Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and who will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. And now we welcome Reverend Rob MacDougall for a moment with children and a message for us all.
Greetings to all of the kids there at Peace United Church of Christ in Schofield. My name is Rob MacDougall, and I'm one of the associate conference ministers here in Wisconsin for the United Church of Christ. And I wanted to offer this time with children. First of all, I wanted to ask you, who among you likes math? That's a subject that some people really enjoy and others not so much. But I wanted to do my time with you today as kind of a math equation. So I've been asked to talk about, in our church, what's called our church's wider mission. Our church's wider mission is also spoken of as OCWM. So I wanted to do some math around OCWM. While I'm here, quarantined in my own home, my granddaughter, who is 17 months old, is living here with us. And she helped me do some drawing. So I wanted to begin with the first drawing that we did. And the first drawing is this one. If you can see it, it is a big O, and it says O equals us and them. Our church's wider mission begins with O. And O means our own church, plus all of the other churches in the United Church of Christ. And God says that we are to love each other, that we are to come together to love our neighbor as ourselves. That's one of the good parts of what Jesus taught us, is how to be God's people together. So our church's wider mission begins with O, and it means us and them together, who we are together, seeking to love as God taught us to. The second letter that my granddaughter helped me make is the letter C, if you can see that, C. And the C stands for giving and receiving. It also stands for the word church. In our tradition, churches are places where people both give of themselves and also receive what they need. Churches and congregations are communities of God's people. We receive what's most important about feeding our spirits and helping us to grow together as a congregation, and then we reach out beyond ourselves. So C, or the word churches, means giving and receiving. The third letter in OCWM is W. And here my granddaughter helped me make another picture of a W. And W stands for wider, and it equals what's possible and what's beyond what we think is possible. In our tradition, we always know that we can't do everything. Not one person can do everything. Not one church can do everything. But together we can do things. So the word wider means what's possible, what we think is possible, what we can do. But then Jesus always asked us to think beyond what we can do. Jesus always says, together we can do anything. So in the church, wider means what's possible for us in our own congregation, but also to think beyond what we can do as a local church. The next letter in our church's wider mission, OCWM, is the letter M. M stands for mission. Oops, I missed my M here. M stands for mission. My granddaughter helped me with this one. And it means call and to take action. So M in mission means our calling, what God calls us to, and then how we respond in the actions that we take in response to that call. So it's a very important part of who we are. Sometimes we're called to help others and do what God wants them to do. God has a mission for everyone. Our job is to listen to God and then respond. So, I'm teaching you about our church's wider mission, OCWM. There it is, OCWM. And what OCWM really means, it means our church's wider mission, but it also means churches together, giving and receiving generously as God calls us to do. So thank you for coming forward and listening to this time with children and learning about our church's wider mission, OCWM. Now may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts gathered here together be acceptable in your sight, O God, for you are our rock and our redeemer. Back in early January, your dancing pastor, Reverend Van Houten, talked to me about coming to Peace United Church of Christ and preaching about what is known as OCWM. I told Pastor Gloria that I would, of course, be glad to do that, but then our world was turned upside down. Who could have guessed that by early March, much of the world that we know would be shut down and we would be sheltering at home? In the last month or two, we have had to adapt, be creative, and overcome incredible odds. Alone and also as we talk together and live out our time together as Christian communities. We have learned that an unseen virus can be more powerful than governments and armies, gold bricks, fame, physical strength, and even the internet. In responding to COVID-19, the Dalai Lama wrote, "We are all the same human beings, and we experience the same fears, hopes, uncertainties, and physical vulnerabilities. The entire world is independent, but as human beings, we all have the capacity to conquer anger and panic and greed." So I come to you this day through the miracle of technology. I am making this video from my home, and you are watching it in your home. And in doing so, we are showing our love for each other and for the world. Day by day, we are learning how to cope with this pandemic. And my prayer to you is a prayer that was written by Saint Francis in Latin. And he used it as a greeting and a farewell. And it goes this way, Pax et bonum, which means peace and well-being or good health. So Pax et bonum to you. Turn with me, if you will, to our scripture passages this morning. In the Gospel of John, Jesus is speaking to a gathered community, and he is making the case that he, Jesus, is the one that has their well-being deepest in his heart. He says he is not like the thief that comes in the night, only to steal and destroy lives. He says, "I have come that you may have life and have it to the full." This is a different message than they had heard before. Jesus is proclaiming that God desires good for them, and Jesus wants them to trust that this is true. If God is the author of life, then the intent of the author is what constitutes the spirit of all things, the breath of life that is breathed into us. To have life to the full, this is God's intent for us in all creation. Jesus implores us to trust this intent. Not long after Jesus' resurrection, his followers began gathering together. In the book of the Acts of the Apostles, we read this. All those who believed in Jesus were gathered and had everything in common. Selling their possessions and goods, they gave to anyone who had need. Their way of being together displayed a deep trust that had grown within the community of believers. They trusted the intent of the author of life. All people in creation were to have life to the full, life in abundance. Life to the full was not unending accumulation, but instead to have and share what is needed. Life to the full was being held and holding others in the bonds of love. Beyond all else, the early followers of Jesus trusted what Jesus proclaimed about God's intention for all people. It is clear that our world functions in dramatically different ways than it did in the first century in Palestine. But over the millennia, those who believed in Jesus continued to trust God's intent and try to reflect it in the way we live. The predecessor denominations of the United Church of Christ kept trying to trust God's intention and live in ways that reflected it. Early church communities learned that they needed the leadership and support of neighboring congregations for them to deepen their faith, grow in love for one another, and serve their communities. So they formed associations and shared their strengths and struggles with each other. Later, as more immigrants came to America, our predecessor people of faith in various geographic regions of the country pooled their resources to start hospitals and colleges, seminaries and orphanages, people to care for the elderly, and all kinds of other ministries. They knew common callings, common ministries, common witnesses. Like the first century church, and like the historic UCC congregations, our current United Church of Christ congregations continue to try to live faithfully as God's people together. Our church's wider mission, OCWM as it is known, is the support that all United Church of Christ churches contribute to the ministries of conferences in the national settings of the United Church of Christ. Each congregation decides what they will give to the larger United Church of Christ as we reflect God's intention that all people in creation experience the fullness of life.
Yeah, it's super nice.
When UCC churches in Wisconsin contribute to our church's wider mission, 75% of all of those contributions stay here within our conference for the state-wide missions and ministries. A significant portion of what stays in our conference goes to support churches that are going through pastoral transitions. Each time your church says goodbye to a pastor, hires an interim pastor, enlists someone for pulpit supply, writes a church profile or reads a pastor's profile. At search and calls a pastor, your OCWM contributions are hard at work. When an individual is experiencing a call to ordained ministry and they enter into what is called a member in discernment status, your OCWM contributions provide resources and guidance, financial support, as together we journey with future leaders of the church. The Wisconsin Conference Lay Academy that enriches, educates, and grows the skills of local church lay leaders would not be possible without your OCWM contributions. In addition to OCWM contributions help support UCC-related colleges and seminaries throughout the Midwest. Our conference camps and programs at Moon Beach, Pilgrim Center, and Cedar Valley are beneficiaries of your OCWM dollars. They help pay for facilities and for staff, Help make these camps available, life-giving, and affordable for everyone who wishes to participate. One of the leading voices during this COVID pandemic is the Wisconsin Council of Churches. They have gathered information, connected denominations, and many faith communities, provided information on safe practices, technology, and government policies. People all around the country have turned to the Wisconsin Council of Churches for direction during these difficult times. Your OCWM dollars help support the Wisconsin Council of Churches. I'm really astonished by the vast ministries that contributions to OCWM support. Care of Creation, support of our pastors, Native American ministries, safe programs for troubled youth, retirement housing for the elderly, innovation grants for new ministries in local congregation, pastoral care, justice witnesses and action, small church visioning, financial planning for churches, and the list just seems to go on and on. Each time your church sees, hears from, or has contact with conference staff, like myself, and national staff, it is because of our church's contributions to OCWM. As your church offers support to OCWM, you are reaching out in seen and unseen ways for your congregation's ministry and for the ministry of your sister churches in places like Wausau and Merrill, Nacusa, Medford, Madeline Island, Platteville, and all our UCC churches in Wisconsin and across the country. In the first century, Scripture says that Jesus' followers gathered their resources together and gave them to all who were in need. They did this because they believed it was God's intention that people and all creation are meant to have life and have it to the full. Today, churches of the United Church of Christ continue to live trusting God's intention. And one way we do this is by gathering our resources together and putting them to use towards God's ministries and missions. I hope your church, Peace United Church of Christ in Schofield, feels a deep sense of joy for all the ways you support ministry in and beyond your church. I say this with gladness in my own heart and in gratitude from all who benefit from your generosity. Blessing, peace, and well-being, pax et bonum, to you this day and every day. Amen.
Thank you.
me in prayer. Good Shepherd, loving Shepherd, our hearts long for you. We need you. Our hearts ache with the images of all the pain and the suffering in our world today. Remind us that the pain of each person is your pain too. You share equally in the sorrow, and yet also remind us of a greater joy. The joy of the unconditional love of God and a peace which surpasses understanding. We need help in silencing the voices of alarm and fear that invade our minds. We need to hear only the sound of your voice speaking to us. Calm our minds. Still our souls. Help us place our deep trust in you to gently lead us through these days. May this be a time of growth in faith, an opportunity to reach out to one another in demonstrating our care, to share the gifts we have, to offer our support in concrete ways, and to reassure each other of the depth of your love and the assurance of your gift of abundant life. Open our eyes to recognize that we are truly in this together, and that only together, in your leading love, will we come through this time of trial. Unite us as one. And remind us, O God, that this is your world. All of humanity is a part of your beautiful creation. Make us aware of the opportunities to serve others in Christ's name. Help us move beyond the comfort of what we know to extend our care to others whom we may not know by name, but are your beloved children too. May your light of love shine in and through us to bring aid and comfort and hope to those in need. We pray for all who find the days too long and simply need someone with whom to talk. We pray for those whose minds are swirling with the questions of what if, and who need the assurance of your continual care. We pray for all who are suffering with physical pain and illness and need your healing touch to make them whole. We pray for those who need the basics of life, food, shelter, and safety. So open our hearts to a generosity of spirit. Unite us with the wider church to meet the needs of your other faith communities of which we are a part. Hear now the silent prayers that are on our hearts. Deepen our faith and help us to love others as you dearly love us. Together we pray as you taught the disciples to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. God's generosity knows no limits. So let us have generous hearts and return a portion of what God has already bestowed upon us in order that we may lift up this church's ministry for others.
Me and
Please join me in prayer. Generous, loving Christ, you came that we might have abundant life. With thankful, joy-filled hearts, we offer our resources and dedicate our lives to you. May these gifts be used to offer life to others in your name. Amen. Let us this week see how we might share our love and our lives for the common good of all. And now may the hope, the peace, and the joy and the love of Christ be with you. Amen.